Micro organisms benefit us in a number of ways. Their uses can be divided into four categories. They are commercial, medicinal, agricultural, and environmental. Now we can discuss one by one. First one, commercial use. Making curd and cheese. Do you know how curd is made at home? Usually, a spoonful of curd is added to warm milk, which turns into curd overnight. This happens because a protein called casein present in milk coagulates to form curd. For casein to coagulate, the milk has to be made acidic. A bacterium called lactobacillus present in the spoonful of curd added to the milk. Convert the lactose sugar present in milk to lactic acid. This creates the acidic environment needed for casein coagulation. Process of conversion of a sugar into an acid or an alcohol by the action of a microorganism is called fermentation. The production of cheese and paneer also involve the use of bacteria such as lactobacillus and streptococcus. The production of alcoholic beverages such as beer and wine involve the fermentation of sugar present in barley and grapes, etc. by a microscopic fungus called yeast. Fermentation by yeast produces alcohol and carbon dioxide. The process of making bread involves kneading a mixture of flour, salt, sugar, yeast cells, and water into a dough. Yeast converts sugar to alcohol and carbon dioxide. As more and more carbon dioxide is produced, the dough rises in volume. This makes the bread porous and spongy. Bacteria are used in the production of vinegar. They are also used in the processing of tea, coffee, and tobacco. Shells of diatoms are used in the toothpaste to give it a gritty texture that helps in cleaning teeth. Xanthan gum obtained from the bacterium Pseudomonas campestris is also used in making toothpaste.